Oh, that's a cool jacket.
Thank you, Anthony. This question here is for Mr. Johnson. I'm Rich Wolowski from Skywalking Through Neverland. I love you all, but this question is for Mr. Johnson. You had said that a lot of the visual cues for The Last Jedi were going to be taken from The Empire Strikes Back. What aesthetic really spoke to you about Empire, and what shot did you really want to replicate from The Empire Strikes Back?
Great. In the ugly light. It's 4 a.m. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here.
Thank you. You're all week.
Well, I mean, my cinematographer, Steve Yedlin, who I've been best friends with since I was 18 years old, we met in film school, and so to be standing next to each other on a Star Wars set was pretty surreal. But I think Empire is, I think it's just the most beautiful. All the films are beautiful. I think for my just taste, I think the cinematography in Empire is the most gorgeous of the whole series. And so Steve and I looked at the lighting in that. It's also kind of the most, it's pretty daring in terms of how dark they were willing to go with some of the, literally dark, and how gorgeous they went with some of the choices they made with the shaping of the lighting. But then in terms of like an actual visual aesthetic, I made a choice very early on that I thought, well, I can either try and kind of copy my idea of what the original movies did, which was much more of kind of a formal, the camera didn't move a ton, and it was much more of kind of the, a much more formal type visual aesthetic. Or I realized, we're going to take visual cues lighting-wise and design-wise from, the previous movies, but I need to just shoot this movie the way that I would shoot a movie. Because at the end of the day, if I'm not engaged with it and I'm not trying to tell the story the way that really makes me excited, then it's not going to be up there on the screen. So I kind of cut myself from loose camera movement-wise and shot-wise from trying to imitate the past and just tried to tell the story as excitingly, is that a word, as I could up on the screen. Yeah.
So there are way more female characters in this movie, certainly than the first three movies. That's going to mean a lot to little girls. I want to know what it means to you guys.
I think, like, as a girl growing up in London, obviously I knew there was a disparity in films, but I wasn't so aware of it. Like, growing up in a liberal household, I was never really made to feel any one way. So when I, like when I got involved, I didn't really... Like, I knew it was a big deal, but the response was so beyond anything I could have imagined that I'm still like, it was only afterwards that I was like, oh yeah. And it's not like I ever took it for granted or anything, but it was just so monumental, the response and how people felt about it. And obviously that's a testament to Kathy, JJ, Michael, Larry, everyone who created the characters in the beginning. And I think what's great about everyone is it's not like, she's a girl, this is a guy, this is anything. Everyone's just, it's just great characters that happily are falling into broader categories now. So I'm thrilled.
I agree. I think that it feels like both an honor and a responsibility at the same time. I feel like from the beginning, when I initially found out I got this role, I just felt like I wanted to do the whole thing justice. And I'm so excited that, guys, the girls in this movie kick some butt. Every single one is so good. And I can't wait for everyone to see it.
Yeah. And I just want to pay tribute to Ryan for being one of the most brilliantly subversive filmmakers I've ever been able to bear witness to. And in the case of the look of my character, I was moved by the fact that he really wanted her strength to first lead with a very deep femininity, and to see a powerful female character also be feminine is something that moves away from a stereotype that's sometimes perceived in strong female characters must be like the boys. Mm-hmm. I thought that was a really interesting choice to get to witness.
I was so delighted. I wasn't cast in the first Star Wars film yet when I heard about the casting. And I was utterly delighted to see that there was a more representative selection of actors that were going to be in these incredible Star Wars films. And that has continued. And everything that my amazing colleagues say is absolutely right. You get to see women that are not being strong just because they're acting like men. They're doing something else. And also you're seeing a developed character, or at least a developing character, that's showing some complex character traits. And I'm just delighted about that. I'm delighted that something as legendary as Star Wars has decided to be modern and to reflect our society more as it is. Mm.